Hi guys, we're at the Las Vegas Aquarium called Sharks Reef. Let's see some sharks and fishies. Let's go!
One of the largest exhibits of its kind, the Shark Reef at Mandalay Bay houses more than 2,000 species of aquatic life, including sharks, exotic fish, giant rays, endangered green sea turtles, piranha, and a Komodo dragon. Johnson's crocodile. All crocodiles are extreme predators. Although Johnson's crocs are sometimes shy, their long snouts are filled with about 70 dagger-like teeth, and a bite can inflict serious damage. These reptiles don't rush about to hunt. They lurk, and then snatch. A crocodile can hold its breath for 2 hours, so it can drag prey underwater and keep it there. The prey usually drowns before it gets eaten. Take it in, but don't look down.
I'm on top of the world. Komodo dragon rules!
Next up, we've got the Komodo dragon, which happens to be Earth's largest lizard. Komodo dragons have voracious appetites and even worse bites. They chow down their prey. Bones, hooves, fur, antlers, skins. Basically, if it fits in their mouth, it's going down their throat.
That's cool! Look at his eyes! By the way. Yeah! They used to be alive, but they got killed or died.
How do these lizards find food? They constantly test the air for smells with their forked, 9-inch tongues. When they scent prey, they attack it with their razor-sharp claws and dagger-like teeth. Also, you might find it interesting to know that their bite is poisonous. Somewhat like a snake, except the venom is very slow acting, so it doesn't kill the prey very fast.
Look at the turtles!
They're glad.
Look at that fish!
There's another one right.
Look at that one! That one's a catfish. It's a beer.
Oh, look at that snake over there.
Bazooka!
Razorback catfish, aka armored cat. Check out the row of horns this catfish has on each side of its sleek body. If a catfish is eaten by a larger predator, those razor-sharp scales make for a nasty mouthful. Moturo stingray, graceful winged swimmer. These stingray are related to marine stingrays. They are specifically adapted to survive in the water with little or no salinity. They are not aggressive, but will defend themselves from predators. How can they do this? On their tail, they have a dangerous, saw-edged, venomous barb. The amazing Amazon. The Amazon may be more critical for human survival than any other place on Earth. It is the world's largest rainforest and river basin and contains an unmatched wealth of plant and animal species. Much of the Amazon is already gone, cleared to make room for cattle ranches, mining, logging, and agriculture. Piranha. These small fish with razor-sharp teeth are well known for their ferocious attacks on prey. Piranha are not nibblers. Their teeth are specialized to seize bite-sized chunks of whatever they're trying to eat. Once excited, many piranha quickly join the fray, and it doesn't take long for them to devour whatever they happen to be eating.
So they will bite?
They could bite. They probably wouldn't. They're pretty timid fish. They're not as bad as most people think.
Okay. But it's a possibility. And they have real sharp teeth. I mean, you don't want to get bit by these teeth, right?
So what do they eat?
Here we feed them mostly bite-sized chunks of fish, sometimes chicken or beef.
Oh, wow. Fish normally don't eat meat, right? Or do they?
Some do. Okay. It just really depends. Yeah, but chicken and beef, that seems kind of weird, right? I mean, a lot of fish eat other fish. That's normal, right?
Okay.
But see, these guys, they're mainly scavengers, so they'll eat anything that dies in the water, right? So sometimes, especially during the rainy season when the river expands, you can have mammals and birds and all kinds of stuff falling in the water, dying. They'll eat those too.
Yeah. You know that some people put their fingers in there and they get bit? Yeah, that's why
nobody's been bit here in the aquarium.
Oh, okay.
But they can bite. Sometimes in the wild, people swim in the Amazon, people get bit, fingers and toes sometimes. But they're not really like attacking people.
Okay. Thank you so much. Have a good day.
Shark! It's a baby hammerhead.
Oh! Here, it's coming.
Hammerhead shark. Most hammerhead species are fairly small and are considered harmless to humans. However, the great hammerhead's enormous size and fierceness make it potentially dangerous, though few attacks have been reported.
Whoa. That's Nemo's friend.
Nemo's friend?
Yeah, Dory. We are going to teleportation! Let's go! Hi, Dory. Look, it's Dory from Nemo.
Jellyfish. The long tentacles trailing from the jellyfish can inject venom from thousands of microscopic barbed stingers. Most often, jellyfish stings cause instant pain and inflamed marks on the skin. Some stings may cause more whole-body systemic illness, and in rare cases, they're life-threatening. Jellyfish can sting you if they brush against you when you're swimming in the ocean. You can also get stung if you step on them, so be careful when you're walking down the beach.
Guys, I have a surprise for you.
There's an octopus!
Octopus. These extremely intelligent creatures with a larger brain for their body size than all animals except birds and mammals. They are capable of higher order cognitive behavior, including tool use and problem solving, even figuring out how to unscrew jar lids for access to food. So basically, they're very smart. Octopuses are curious creatures and generally not aggressive towards people, but they will defend themselves if provoked and are capable of causing serious injuries.
Hello, Mr. Octopus. Wait. And what's your name, Mr. Krabs? There's a starfish right here. I'm trying to blend in with the rock.
Starfish. The spinny skin's colors act as a camouflage to help them blend into their environment. Some species have bright colors to scare off or confuse attackers. Instead of blood, starfish have a seawater vascular system that circulates nutrients and powers their tube feet, allowing them to move about their environment. Do starfish bite? No, they don't bite. They don't have any teeth, and they're not dangerous to humans. These small sea creatures are not exactly known for their voracious appetite, so no need to worry if one happens to be near you when you're swimming in the ocean.
So many stingrays.
Stingrays. They are curious and playful animals when there are divers and snorkelers around. And if they feel threatened, their first instinct is to swim away. Stingrays have venomous spines on their tails. Although they are generally shy, they may strike when unintentionally stepped on by thrusting its tail into your leg or foot. Venom and spine fragments can cause the wound to become infected. Stingray stings usually cause intense pain, nausea, weakness, and fainting. Although most people recover completely, stingray stings can cause serious infection or allergic reactions in some cases. If you get stung by a stingray, you should wash the wound and seek medical care quickly. Red lionfish. The red lionfish is a venomous coral reef fish. Lionfish have 18 venomous spines that are capable of penetrating human skin and delivering a very painful, but not fatal, sting. As lionfish populations grow, they put additional stress on coral reefs. For example, lionfish eat herbivores and herbivores eat algae from coral reefs. Without the herbivores, the algae can become overgrown and cause issues with the overall health of the coral reef.
Anyways, let's look at some sharks.
Sharks. There are over 500 species. Some are speedy, some are slow. Some sharks are large, others are itty-bitty. Some are well-known, while many others remain less familiar. Many feast on fish, while others prefer to slurp worms or filter plankton. Their ancestors swam the seas before dinosaurs roamed the land. Though in popular culture, sharks are large, toothy creatures to be feared, this is not always the case. In fact, many sharks around the world need protections that can help maintain a healthy ocean for generations to come. All sharks share these important characteristics. Soft skeletons. No bones, no problem. Instead of the hard bones that make up the human skeleton, sharks have softer skeletons made of cartilage, similar to what we have in our noses and ears. 5 to 7 gill slits. Sharks have 5 to 7 gill slits on each side of the body. Gills are a shark's respiratory organ. Gases are exchanged with the water that flows over them. In its simplest form, oxygen is absorbed and carbon dioxide is released. Fins for swimming, steering, and balance. Sharks swim using their caudal fin, which is sometimes called the tail fin. Sharks generate swimming power by moving their caudal fin from side to side. Pectoral fins, found on the shark's side behind the gills, are used for lift and steering. The dorsal fin is used for balance. It keeps the shark upright and stabilized, preventing it from rolling or spinning. I've tried to cut these corners, try to take the easy way. I kept on falling short of something. Teeth that regrow. A shark's teeth fall out throughout its life and are continuously replaced. This is called revolver dentition. very different than humans, right? Because, you know, once you get your grown-up teeth, you're done getting teeth. If one of them happens to come out, you have to get a fake tooth, right? Where sharks, even if they lose a tooth, they just grow a new one. Pretty cool, huh? Bowmouth guitarfish. The bowmouth guitarfish, also called a shark ray, looks a lot like a shark, but they're actually rays. Since sharks and rays are closely related, it can sometimes be hard to tell the difference. An easy way to tell is by looking at the location of the gill slits. If the gills are on the side of the fish, then you're looking at a shark. If they're on the underside, it's a ray.
Saw sharks are rare and unique sharks. They are characterized by a long, slender saw-like snout, equipped with sharp tooth-like projections on each edge, which they use to slash and disable their prey.
Sure is. You pick it up.
Yeah. It won't bite you, so it's dead.
Yeah, it's not going to do anything to you.
What is this?
That's a shark egg. Hatched out of an egg like that just a few months ago. So with sharks, most of them actually give live birth, but there are some that do lay eggs. It just depends on the species.
Mm-hmm. What kind of mouth is that from?
This is from the bowmouth guitarfish. Did you guys see that one? Swimming around in there?
Yeah.
Basically like a big giant ray, like to swim at the bottom. He has these rounded teeth, uses them for crushing and grinding. He's got very powerful jaws.
We heard that he will eat anything.
The sawfish, they'll eat all kinds of stuff too. Same with the bowmouth. These guys mostly prefer crustaceans, things like crab, lobster, stuff like that. That's why they have these teeth. They kind of crush and grind back through them.
What is this skull from?
A sea turtle. So we have three green sea turtles here. Two of them are about 40 years old, one's about 60 years old. Yeah.
I've heard that Galapagos turtles can live to 180.
Yeah, the oldest living one right now, I think, is they estimated between 180 and 190. They're still alive right now. Yeah, they can. They can live a long time. The tortoises and sea turtles as well. They can live a very, very long time. So this is called chainmail. So a diver will wear an entire suit made of this, okay, covering their whole body. All right, it's basically protection from shark bite. All right, so a shark tries to bite, it stops the teeth from going through. It doesn't stop the pressure, so one can still get injured that way, but it will stop the laceration.
Touch it, Jake. It's soft.
It's soft, very flexible, and the entire suit weighs about 15, 20 pounds.
So, are the sharks mammals then, or no?
No, they're technically fish. They're cartilaginous fishes. So.
Okay.
So just live birth is there. You know, there's reptiles, there's fish that do live birth as well. I'm sure is that why you asked?
Because you mentioned live birth.
So the thing that separates mammals from everything else is the production of milk for the young, because the mammary gland.
Yeah.
So that's what really makes it a mammal or not. So
okay.
There are fish, there are reptiles that give live birth as well.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
And the Komodo dragon's poisonous?
Yes, they do have venom in their saliva. It is a more slow-acting venom, so it's not like a venom that's going to kill you right away or anything. Typically, those guys just, anything they're going for, they're usually just going to kill it with brute force before the venom does anything.
Okay.
But say it just happens to get away right there. Like say it's got a deer, it's shining, the deer gets away, that deer is going to die within a day or two, and they have a great sense of smell, they will track it down. Yeah.
I hear stuff in
there. I think there's just some sand in there or something. I'm not sure. Something gets stuck in there. See that hole in the middle right there? That's his mouth.
Put it next to your ear and see if it makes noise. Like a humming noise. No, do it. There's nothing living in there. Is it humming?
Sea stars are pretty cool. So sea stars, they like to eat shellfish, oysters, clams, mussels, stuff like that. They rip the shells open and they eat, so they're very strong. I don't know if you ever tried to open an oyster or a clam or something. So they rip them right open and they eat the inside. It's something that's really cool about sea stars. See that mouth there? It's not very big, right? So when they eat, what they do is their stomach comes out of their mouth and wraps around their food, digest the food, and then when they're all done, they pull their stomach back into their mouth.
Wow.
I know, pretty weird, right?
That's
crazy. It works for them.
That's crazy. All right. Thank you so much.
Yeah, I will see you again.
Thank you, you too.